had his breakfast spread and invited the general to join him at breakfast. So he said, I'm surprised at your calmness. You're so not upset at all. You know what is going to happen. He said, yes, but this is my morning schedule. I pray and I have breakfast. And then he invited, of course, nobody joined. He finished his breakfast and then he said, let's go. And he went, arrested him, took him out, and made him. So this is again one of those things that we talked about. Now, Hyderabad city, when it was founded, the Sultan issued a decree, Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah, build a city which should be a replica of heaven and unfounded in the world. That is according to Erishta, the historian. Now, this you might say is a hyperbole. Everybody says best in the world and so on. So, a replica of heaven, which means very beautiful. No. A German architect has come out with an interpretation in the Islamic journal, Studies of Islamic Journal, and I assume that if it got it published there, it would have been accepted. He says, no, it was a real attempt at creating architectural metaphor for Islamic heaven. Now, Islamic heaven, briefly, is the word for heaven in Arabic is Jannat. Jannat in Arabic also means garden. So first, the widespread gardens there. We have evidence that the city had less than 3 square kilometers of vegetation and 23 square kilometers of greenery in and around the city. That is one. Then, in the Islamic heaven, there is a fountain. From the fountain flow 4 canals. They call it rivers, they have the canals. Of pure water, pure milk, pure honey, pure sugar. Now, that fountain, which is called Chasuka Hall, which means four directions, it is still there. Gulzar House is called now. You can still see there. And if you see old photographs of the that Gulzar House, around that was a big garden. But when the traffic changed from the earlier traffic of there was hardly any vehicle traffic, horses and so on. And gradually cars came and so on. So you see gradually that shrinking. Then in Islamic heaven there are 2 types of trees, Tala and Sidr. Now there are no counterpart trees on earth. So here they planted coconut, palm trees and betelnut trees to represent these 2 trees and so on. So the points are many. There are some points which will be rather technical, I won't go into it, but it is actually in my book, published in 1994, and there hasn't been any objection from any quarter. So, to say that this is what was a representation of the Islamic heaven is very correct. And now, you know, when the chit comes, you know what it is. You notice. So, I'll now come to the last point. That is, we generally boast about the composite culture of Hyderabad.